In a recent keynote, Jakob was asked about new technologies and how they impact the user experience.
Oh, I mean, that's very interesting. And I think for AI, it's that's kind of an evolving area, because it used to be that it was just too bad for any kind of practical use. And now it's kind of reasonably good, but it's to the point where some of the more simplistic things like speech recognition works reasonably well. But then natural language comprehension doesn't work nearly as well. So if you ask things like the Amazon Echo, the Alexa device, you say, Alexa, some question. She may well get the words right in your question, but then she'll still say, but I don't know the answer to that question. That's very common, unfortunately, right now, that or misunderstand it. So we still have, you know, some ways to go. Ultimately, I don't believe that any of that AI will kind of really solve our user experience problems, because we still have that kind of like that gap between user intention and machine kind of execution of our commands. And I mean, you know that even if you had we have intelligence in the world already. It's just called natural intelligence, right? So you know that if you ask somebody to do something, it doesn't mean that they actually do what you want them to do. And even people don't understand each other perfectly either. So I don't think I don't think we will get like the perfect usability, you know, like just because we have things like speech comprehension. Or I mean, there will definitely be some advantages for sure. I mean, we already know that it's kind of alleviated one of the problems with the mobile devices, which is that it's very painful to type. So if you can speak a message rather than typing a message, then that becomes easier. So there are definitely advantages to it, but I don't think they solve all problems. Also, I'm actually really a big kind of screen size bigot. I mean, I really believe that the big screens have their place in the world, and showing people a lot of stuff is really advantageous to that kind of thinner communication channel of the spoken word. So I believe a lot in terms of direct manipulation of the visual graphical user interface style. So I think that there are places, you know, cases where, you know, speech has a great role, and there are other cases where visual have a great role. And I think we will actually end up with much more of a blended interaction style than just one thing in the future.